How does your personality kind of jive with Coach Diaz to kind of bring the kind of defense that you're talking about?
Well, you know, it's the first time he and I actually have gotten a chance to sit down and really visit. But, you know, we had some brief conversations, but our philosophies are very simple. You know, we're aggressive. And the three things that I believe he's looking for and I'm looking for, and we've kind of talked about it, we want to play smart. And anytime people send our tape out, they look at Mississippi State and go, these guys play smart. They've got answers. And I don't mean answers at halftime. I mean answers during the middle of a series. Two, that they're going to play hard, in which they did a tremendous job a year ago of doing. They're exciting, and they play hard. And third, that we're the most physical football team in the country, not in just in the SEC, but that we're physical. And when you play us, you're gonna be in a physical day. And again, the expectation of winning, not of being close, but the expectation of winning. And that's the culture that I believe that Coach Mullen is bringing to this program.
Coach Diaz, any preconceptions about defensive schemes that you're bringing to this, or just take the personnel you've got?
And that's the first thing you always have to do. I mean, number one, you got to make sure that the kids can do it, that they can handle that. You know, whatever it is, you could decide to do 8 million things that are all great, and the kids can't handle it. So, but what I can't wait for, because you know, and I know how Coach Mullen is. I know that he's a great football mind, and Chris the same way. I just can't wait for us all to get in there and say, it's a rare opportunity where you can say, okay, let's erase this board. If you had to dream it up again today, what do you want to be? And you guys were, what were you in tackle philosophy? Like,
two or three,
you know what I mean? Yeah. I mean, so you're, I look at it as a blessing.
It is.
I mean, you have Coach Mullen, who, great offensive mind, pretty sure he's going to have a good idea on what offenses don't like to see. And then you have these two philosophies that are going to be in some ways very close, but maybe it may be a way that you said something, a way that just a minor detail. I think people often mistake, they look at the big picture things, which are actually less important, you know, the way that you're going to line up, or whether it's man or zone, or what type of zone, or whatever. That to me is not, that's not the answer. If it was, then like everyone would be doing that. It's maybe a little detail in terms of how you coach this this stunt or this movement or this coverage. And if we can do that, we just want our kids to have every advantage possible when they take the field. So I look at this as absolutely a blessing for me at this point in my career, and then hopefully it'll filter down to the kids, because those are the ones that got to play.
For Chris, you know, it's so late in the 2010 class, but what do you envision your role being in these last couple of weeks before signing day?
Signing every top player in the state of Mississippi, period. I mean, there is no – that's our goal, is to take the best kids in Mississippi and have them go to Mississippi State University. It's a great university. Me coming here, you know, and actually getting down to see it and have a chance to be on seven staffs and seeing a place like this. You sit back and go, this place has a chance, you know, and obviously if we can lock up our state, we've got a chance to play with anybody in our conference, anybody in the country. So that's our goal, is to finish this deal up, get into every home, and establish a relationship with the guys we have, and show them why this is a great place, and we got a great plan for them. That it's not just a feel-good deal. We got a great plan for them.
Do you intend to wear the ring when you recruit?
Yeah, probably. You know, I